Thank you. The service victim from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, be not wise in your own conceits. To no man render evil for evil, but provide good things, not only in the sight of God, but also in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as far as in your lives, be at peace with all men. Do not avenge yourselves, beloved, but give place to the works. For it is written, vengeance is mine. I will obey, says the Lord. But if your enemy is hungry, give him food. If he is thirsty, give him drink. For by so doing, you will heap coals of fire upon his head. Be not overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. The mission of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, when Jesus had come down from the mountain, great crowds followed him. And behold, a leper came up and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if you will, you can make me clean. And stretching forth his hands, Jesus touched him, saying, I will, be made clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. And Jesus said to him, "See that you tell no one, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a witness to them." Now when he had entered Capernaum, there came to him a centurion who entreated him, saying, "Lord, my servant is lying sick in the house, paralyzed, and is grievously afflicted." Jesus said to him, "I will come and cure him." But in answer, the centurion said, "Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a man subject to authority, and have soldiers subject to me. And I said to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes, and to my servant, 'Do this,' and he does it." And when Jesus heard this, he marveled, and said to those who were following him, "Amen, I say to you, I have not found such great faith in Israel. And I tell you that many will come from the east and from the west, and will preach with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the children of the kingdom will be put forth into the darkness outside. There will be weeping and the gnashing of teeth." Then Jesus said to the centurion, Go you away as you have believed, so be it done to you." And the servant was healed in that hour. Today, the third Sunday of Epiphany. This week, on Monday, the feast of the conversion of Saint Paul. On Tuesday, Saint Polycarp, bishop and martyr. On Wednesday, Saint John Chrysostom, bishop and doctor of the Church. On Thursday, Saint Peter Nolasco, confessor. On Friday, Saint Francis de Sales, bishop, confessor, and doctor of the Church. And on Saturday, Saint Martina, bishop and martyr. Next Sunday, to be the Septuagesima Sunday. This week we have two masses in the morning, 7:15 and 9:20, the Rosary in the afternoon at 5:30, and on Friday, the low mass at 6 in the afternoon, after the morning is normal schedule, with Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock, children and adults catechism. You were able to notice that we have a beautiful choir. They work to sing the masses, but we need some more men voices. So please, if you are a man, if you are a boss, don't hesitate to join the choir in the script, but legally we need you. Regarding the parish tea, we have this parish tea every Sunday after Mass. We can ask those who attend to bring a time something for the parish tea. And the last thing is that a few days ago, we did celebrate the 25th year of presence of Sister Elizabeth here in the parish. She arrived 25 years ago in this parish. And I've been serving the parish since then, Sister Elizabeth from America. So we thank her for this long year of work here at the parish. We thank also the other sisters who are there. And it's an occasion to pray also for vocation. And we pray for vocation not only for priests and brothers, but also for nuns, for religious sisters. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. That's good. We have just heard in the Gospel these beautiful words of the centurion. "Domine non sum dignus." Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my servant shall be healed. And he explained, "I have men under my authority. If I tell them go, they go. If I tell them do this, they do it. So, in Latin America, you, your God, your Christ is the world, and it will be He. What's the beautiful profession of faith? You can do it. You are God. And our Lord Himself is impressed by this answer. And says, I have not found so great faith in Israel. That means, I have not found so great faith among the Jews. And so, He prophesies the conversion of many pagans to the true faith. And the loss of some Jews who don't want to be saved. Many will come from the east and from the west. Because He indeed came on earth for the salvation of all. He wants to save everyone. Not only the Jews, His people, who are to welcome the Messiah in their home, but all people. We do believe that God wants the salvation of everyone. It is one main difference we have with the Protestants, at least with most of the Protestants, at least with Calvinists. They believe in the double predestination. Some are predestined to salvation by God, and some are predestined to damnation, to hell. Which means God does not want to save everyone. And that is wrong. Of course, if we are saved, it means that we have been predestined to be saved. God wants us to save us. But if we are not saved, it does not mean that God did not want to save us. God wants to save everyone. But everyone is not saved. Because some people refuse to be saved. Refuse to be loved. Refuse to love in return. Refuse to do the will of God. It is the mystery of human free will. We have been created in God's image. This is of free will. We can say yes. We can say no. Therefore, today, reading at this verse 10, when our Lord says that He is going to save everyone, not only the Jews, but everyone, the first rejoice as a goodness of God. It is the goal of the incarnation to save. Our Lord said, I did not come to judge, but to save. To save from eternal damnation. And everyone can be saved. Does not matter from where we come. Every human being is called to salvation. But we must be willing to. We must accept God's grace as it passes by. We cannot postpone. I will come back one day. No. Don't put off until tomorrow what you can do today. I don't know if I will receive another grace of conversion. I don't know if I will be able in the future. So we must pray for conversion. For our own conversion, if we are not yet a Catholic, to be able to accept this grace. And for the conversion of people who we know and who are not yet Catholic. We do know a lot of non-Catholics. Let us pray for them. Everyone is called to salvation. Our Lord died for them as well. And that is the source of the respect we have for others. Any soul has been created by God in order to be saved. Our Lord, with God, gave His blood for every soul. That is the true reason why we have to respect, to honor, to be charitable with anyone. Respect for souls with humility. In the feast of today, we have been told, be not wise in your own conceit. Only God does judge. It does not mean we have to accept and tolerate everything, of course not. Evil is evil. But we must have, we try to have towards our neighbor the same attitude God does belongs to us. Patience, goodness, mercy. He wants to save. Again, the Easter, if your enemy is hungry, give him to eat. If he thirsts, give him to drink. Have peace with all men. This peace of God, without compromising this error, and our lives, being tolerant for sin, but full of mercy for sinners. And it is saying in our epistle again, be not overcome by evil, but overcome evil by good. Let us have faith in the power of the grace of God. Let us never despair of our fellow men. God wants to save them as well. Let us always pray for their salvation. A few years ago, it was in Paris. A group of Catholics used to gather on Saturdays in front of an abortion clinic to pray for all the victims of abortion, for the mothers, for the doctors. And every time they had to face in front of them a group of opponents, quite violent, throwing tomatoes, eggs, insulting, blaspheming, shouting. And you could even see the hatred on their face. On the other side, the faithful were peaceful, praying quietly in their own way, patiently, never answering anything. Among the opponents, there was an old man, long hair, very aggressive. He was very faithful, you could say, to this meeting. Could not miss one, but always there, pointing the ones who were praying, blessing. And our good Catholics were praying for their opponents, and especially for him, because he was always there. And one day, they did not see him. He was not there. He did appear for a few months. And on the Saturday, they saw him again. But he was not in front of them, pulling them. He was with them, praying, surrounded with them. The power of the grace of God. The prayers, the goodness, patience, the faithfulness of these few souls did merit the conversion of this man. Be not overcome by evil, but overcome evil by good. So today let us renew our faith in the grace of God. God who wants to save everyone. Let us simply pray for our salvation and for the salvation for the conversion of people we know. Let us retain our faith, reading the words of the centurion of the gospel today. Lord, I am not worthy, but only say the word. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Alors, comme elle est venue, mais vraiment,